Is busy, is visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today we'll discuss about that classification of dogs we have completed. Today we'll discuss about selection of dog breeds and their major traits. So now, how this one, all of us, or many of us, we are interested to have at least one pet dog at home. Then the question is, which one will be the best for me or for us? So accordingly, some may like some other type of breeds, maybe a big size, maybe very beautiful one, or maybe very intelligent one, like that. So here, what we should do is we should have knowledge, certain knowledge of the different dog breeds, which are commonly available in our country and abroad. So when we, before deciding or at the time of taking decision, which type of dog breed I should have. So main thing is, although there are seven different groups of dogs as per the American Kennel Club. So out of those seven groups, so many dog breeds are there. So there, what is most important is, if I am interested in a, say, guard dog, so there, then instead of going directly on the characteristics of the dog groups, it's better to have the knowledge about the specific breed. Okay, but because a dog breed may be in a hunting group, but the characteristics, some of its characteristics may be fulfilling the requirement of some other groups, means a group, a dog breed may be in more than one groups. Then, before going into the individual characteristics of the different dog breeds, we also should have about the knowledge of different dog groups. So then, once we have the idea about the different dog groups, then we can understand, yes, exactly this particular breed is in this particular group. So in a generalized way, this particular dog breed will have this so-and-so characteristics. So coming to that, this one, individual dog breed characteristics, now I am just again refreshing about this one, seven main dog groups as classified by American Kennel Club. First is sporting dog. Sporting dogs usually make well-rounded companions. Horned dogs used for hunting, their purpose is mainly for hunting in the earlier times. Working dogs perform various jobs for human, like rescue, like this one is in the police and other active services also. Terriers notorious for being lively and feisty. Toys popular for small places in cities. Herding dogs like German Shepherd and all, excellent companion and respond well to training, means easy to train. Non-sporting dogs, most diverse dog breeds here. So one by one, I will be giving here. So now coming to the sporting dogs, please, we discussed earlier, but let us have some, again, background knowledge. They are the natural athletes, active, and however, they require regular and stimulating exercise because they are used for sporting purposes. They are very active. Therefore, when they are not doing this type of job, they should be given regular exercise. So those things are required. So while deciding a dog breed for as a companion animal, so we have to decide whether I have the time to give this proper exercise to my dog. Then their personality range from the mild to hard-headed, or means a lot of variation is there in their personalities. And breeds are Golden Retriever, Labrador Retriever, Setters, Spaniels, and Pointers. And then one by one, breeds also we'll discuss today. Then hound dogs here. First one is this Afghan hound, and they are generally used for hunting purpose. And however, they are very difficult to train. Then the breeds are Afghan Horn, Beagle, Greyhound, Dachshund. Then working dogs here, they are strong, intelligent, and watchful, and size is medium to giant size. And due to the size, many of them are not suitable for certain living situation. If you are staying in a very small room, then this big size dog may not be a breed of choice, and they require proper training in their younger stage of life to make them very sincere and obedient. Now, then coming to the terrier here, most terrier require, again, they require regular training and special grooming as per their type of the coat. And most of them are not generally good for roadie children, means for with the children, if the children are not behaving properly. So for them, this type of dog breeds, that is dogs which comes under terrier are not good. They are tough to train. Then the breeds are Border Terrier, Irish Terrier, etc. Now coming to the toys, very popular dog breeds, for especially for the ladies and all. And here comes your Pomeranian, then Chihuahua, then Pug, then Maltese, like this. However, these small dog breeds, which comes under this toy group, they have the tendency of barking, means a lot of noise maybe there. And generally, they don't like the small children. Then coming to the herding dogs here, very popular one is German Shepherd. You might have seen many a times. They are intelligent, courageous, and excel in police work, search and rescue, tracking, and they are used for helping the handicapped peoples. Then herding dogs make excellent companions and respond well to training. And these dog groups, they are generally good for services like helping aged peoples, handicapped peoples, and all those peoples. Now then, non-sporting group. Here is a very varied group, means a lot of variation is there. And their personalities, as I mentioned, bulldog is very calm, but Dalmatian is very high energy and very active one. So these dogs of this group, they are of different types of personalities. So the main breeds are bulldog, poodle, Dalmatian, and etc. So now coming to the major breeds, so these are the commonly used or seen dog breeds in India: Alsatian or German Shepherd, Beagle, Boxer, Bulldog, Dachshund, Dalmatian, Doberman Pinscher, Great Dane, Greyhound, Lhasa Apso, Poodle, Pug, Labrador, Golden Retriever, Cocker Spaniel, Saint Bernard, Pointer, Rottweiler, Collie, etc. So let us try to have some specific characteristics of these different dog breeds commonly seen in our country. Now coming to the German Shepherd, as we know, they are also known as Alsatian. Okay, they are large type breed, and their lifespan is 7 to 10 years. It's a comparatively shorter. And here, these are the photographs of the German Shepherd. They are very friendly with the kids. Then here, temperament. When we talk about the temperament of the German Shepherd, they are gentle, intelligent, good temper, kind, outgoing. Tendency to bark, they rarely bark. Tendency to snore is low. Good sweet kids and the other pets if rise together. If you want to have a cat also, so other type of dog breeds also in that situation, if they rise together from the childhood, then they are very good to each other. Then grooming moderately required. So here again, when you are looking for a dog breed, you have to see whether you can spare your time for grooming. So frequent grooming, then very less grooming, then moderately grooming. So here German Shepherd requires moderately grooming is required. Colors commonly tan with black saddle, as this particular breed is very famous, everybody needs. Then other traits are need ample exercise daily, so you have to spare your time for exercise daily. Easy to train, they are very trainable. Great watchdog ability. Okay, if you are having a very big house and all, so this dog may be very useful as a guard dog. Then coming to the Beagle here, it is a size is small type, and from United Kingdom, another name is English Beagle. Then these are the photographs of the beagle, dog breeds. Now coming to the temperament here, they are very friendly, gentle, independent, intelligent also, then good with kids and other pet animals. Tendency to bark is very high. So if you are not interested to any type of dog which barks very frequently, then this may not be a breed of choice for you. Then tendency to snore is low. Grooming is little required here. Less time is required for grooming. Then other traits are a hunting dog and very suitable pets for the home. Now coming to the boxer, it is from Germany and size is very large. Then these are the photographs of the boxer. And here, temperament wise, boxer, they are very brave, confident, energetic, friendly, fearless, good with kids. If you are having small kids, then this one you can have. Tendency to bark is low. Tendency to snore is moderate. Grooming is very little required as the hair coat type is very smooth and short. Then other traits are, they are very easy to train, high energy level and needs plenty of exercise. Every day they have to be brought out for exercise. Now coming to the bulldog, it is again from United Kingdom. Size is medium and lifespan is 8 to 10 years. These are the photographs of the bulldog. You may be very aware about this photograph also, that is bulldog. Now the characteristics are here. When we talk of temperament, then they are very friendly, courageous, and generally not brutal, but the look, their looks is very dangerous, but they don't attack the people. They are good with the kids. Tendency to bark is low, but snoring tendency is very high. Grooming is moderately required. Then other traits are, they are very difficult to train, not suitable for a first-time dog owner. If you are interested to have a dog for the first time, then this bulldog may not be the breed of choice. Then coming to the Dachshund, it is again from Germany, horn type, and same horn breeds, this one, United Kingdom Kennel Club, they classify it in the same horn because when they are used for hunting, they trace the prey as per the smell. So they are the smallest, they may be of different types, smallest, small, medium. Then the smallest one is considered as a toy breed. Then these are the images here. There are two types. One is long hair and another is short hair. So this short hair will require less grooming time or less grooming is required. Then for long hair, more or frequent grooming is required. So here, temperament here, they are clever, courageous, and moderately easily trainable. Good with kids? No, they are not good with kids. In isolation might not be the best option for kids. For example, if you are keeping this type of dog breed along with your small children, then they are not a good one. Grooming is moderately required. Colors in different types, as you have seen, that is the. Then here coming this Dalmatian. It is a unique characteristic, spots, black or brown spots are there, or liver spots. Here it is again from Croatia, Dalmatia region of Croatia. Classification is non-sporting, and then United Kingdom classification is companion dog, medium-sized breed. Coming to the characteristics here, these are the two photographs. One is for adult, another one is for pup. And here one drawback of the Dalmatian dog is they are very prone to deafness when they become aged and urinary stones. So as a clinician also, you are supposed to have this idea about the dog. If it is a Dalmatian breed, this type of problem may come up when they are aged. Then coming to the temperament here, they are very intelligent, playful, friendly and outgoing. Tendency to bark and snore is low. Good with children, family and the other dogs if they are kept together. Grooming requires very low. Colors white with black spots. Other traits are, they are very easy to train. However, they are not suitable for apartment dwellers. If you are staying in an apartment, in that situation, they are, may not be the choice of breed. However, they are very good watchdog. So if you are having a single building house, having a lot of area, for this one, lawn area is there and all, so space, if it is available, then this Dalmatian is suitable. Then Doberman Pinscher, as you are very familiar with this dog breed, it is again from Germany and was developed by the Carl Friedrich Louis Doberman. So the name Doberman was given. The background for development of this type of breed by the Doberman was, he was a tax collector. So at the time of his tax, collection of the tax, he needs a guard. So he tried to have a dog which he developed as a guard dog so that he can go along with him. So then coming to the classification, American class is working class, then UK class is Guardian. So it is a medium large breed, not a very giant breed also, and not a small, it is a medium large, as you are very familiar with this one. Here, there are two photographs of the Doberman Pinscher. So it is a black in color. And in earlier time, docking was permitted. There is the amputation of the dog. Nowadays, it is not permitted. So coming to the temperament here, they are intelligent, fearless, tendency to bark, low. Whether they are good with the kids, yes, they are good with the kids. Grooming requires moderate. Then other traits are, as guard dogs, also have been police and the military dogs, rescue dogs, and the therapy dogs. So this is a very popular dog breed, Doberman is, and they are having multi-purposes and their utility is in many fields. And they are very powerful and energetic dogs, needs a lot of exercise. If they are not exercised, then what they will do? They are more likely to become irritable and or even aggressive. This thing we should keep in our mind when we are going for Doberman. They have to be put under vigorous exercise. Now coming to the Great Dane, a giant dog here. It is from Germany. It is also known as German Mastiff and one of the largest dog breeds. Then these are the photographs of the Great Dane. You might be very familiar with this one. this way or that way, you might have seen it. Then temperament-wise, they are friendly, devoted, confident, good with kids, yes, they are good. Grooming required is less. Utility and other traits are, they are descendant from hunting dogs known as in the Middle Ages. Means their forefathers were a hunting dog. Coming to the Greyhound here, American classification is Hound. And then UK classification, Sighthound. Sighthound means those dog breed who trace the prey after seeing its target. That is once the prey is observed to this dog, then they generate targets in that time. Their size is very large and speed is, see here, 72 kilometers per hour. And again, you see these photographs here on the right-hand side. These Greyhound, they are very athletic and they have a lot of stamina to run for a longer period of time to chase down the prey. So nowadays in the Arab countries and other parts of the world, they are used in the racing. So they are intelligent, gentle, and no aggressiveness towards other dogs. Tendency to bark is low and snore is also low. And they are good with the kids. Then other traits are, they require less exercise, spend most of the day sleeping. They prefer to sleep most of the day. Then social attention needs moderate. Their grooming low as the coat is short. And retired racing greyhounds are adopted as a family pet. Mainly they are used nowadays for race purpose. Once they are retired from the race purpose or racing purpose, they are used as a family pet. And Lhasa Apso here, It is from Tibet, non-sporting, UK classification is companion dog. They are small size dog. These are the photographs of the Lhasa Apso, very fancy dog, long hair. Then they are playful, intelligent, friendly, fearless. Tendency to bark is very high, as this most of the toy breeds, they are having this tendency to bark so frequently. And as tendency to snore is low, good with children. Grooming require very high grooming, or as the coat is long and straight. Other traits are traditionally they are used as indoor guard and companion dog. If you are staying in the compartment and all, so in that situation, Lhasa Apso may be one of the choice. Then Pomeranian, this one is very familiar to all of us. It originated from Germany and the Poland. United Kingdom classification is toy. Then UK classification is companion dog. They are a small, a true toy dog. Weight is here, you have around, it is 3.5 kg or 4 kg is the maximum. And lifespan is longer because they are the small size dog, that is 12 to 16 years of age. Now here they are very playful, intelligent, friendly, but easy to train. Tendency to bark is very more. Most of the time they used to bark for a small thing also, but they are kid friendly. Grooming is moderately required. Colors may be in different types of colors, white, then brown, or this one orange color. Other traits are excellent watchdog with their alert attitude and their tendency to bark. If someone or stranger is there, they used to bark, so accordingly the owner is alerted. Now here is brown color, named after the Pomerania region in Poland and East Germany, descended from larger Spitz type dog. Good for small apartment, good for novice owner. If you are a first time dog owner, then this one is a breed of choice. Then coming to the poodles, as I mentioned, there are different types of poodles. The medium poodle variety is not universally recognized. Toy poodle, then standard poodle. Standard poodle is used as a horn dog, toy poodle as a toy dog. Now here, let us see toy poodles here. These are the pictures. They have originated from France and Germany. Size is very small, again, and their lifespan is almost similar to that of Pomeranian, that is 12 to 15 years. And these are some of the photographs of the toy poodles with different colors. And they look like a teddy bear here, but these are the actual photographs. Then, temperament-wise, they are intelligent, easy trainable, petful. Tendency to bark is low. Yes, good with kids. Grooming is very difficult to do due to their type of hair. And good for novice owners. Yes, they are good. And good for apartment living. For those who are living in the small apartment also, this is a breed of choice. Now, Puck, very familiar one, very popular one. It originated from China. It is a toy type, very small. And lifespan is 12 to 15. And these are some of the photographs of the pug. Now they are very playful, charming, stubborn, docile, mischievous, clever. All those good characteristics are there. Tendency to bark is low. Good with kids, yes. Grooming less, as they have a very fine and a glossy coat. And first time owners, it is good. And they have the characteristics as an ideal house dog, adapts well in apartment living. Labrador Retriever. Here, it originated from United Kingdom and Canada. The other name is Lab, your Lab. Just like in your practical UZ Lab, like that. Sporting group, size is medium. Then here is a photographs of Labrador of different colors, liver color or brown, black, white, or creamy. Then good for a family looking for a medium to large dog. It is an ideal breed for search, rescue, detection, and therapy work. Then coming to their temperament, they are good temper and easy to train. They are good with the kids, other pet animals. Tendency to bark and snore is low. Grooming, no need of lots of fancy grooming. Easy care dogs, they don't require much grooming. Other traits are they are excellent family dog, needs moderate exercise. Then coming to the golden, again, it is very famous one, very popular one. They have originated from United Kingdom, and they comes under the group Sporting, under American classification. Then United Kingdom classification, it comes under gun dog. Their size is medium to large. And here are the photographs of the this one adult golden retriever and the pups. If exercise is provided daily, can adapt to any type of home, even if it is a city apartment. Means here, this is the point here. You might have seen in many of the big houses and bungalows also, these dogs are there. So if regular exercise is given daily, then they can adapt to any type of living situations. So they are very friendly, intelligent, and good with kids, dogs, and the other cats. Tendency to bark is moderate and snore is low. Grooming requires moderately. Colors, golden or various shades, dark golden, light golden. They are very easy to train, service dogs for disabled and search and rescue dogs. Very versatile dog in terms of their utilities. And here you can have Labrador Retriever and the Golden Retriever. There are two photographs. One is Labrador, another is Golden. So these are their characteristics. One is having short hair, smooth hair, and one is a longer coat. Then English Cocker Spaniel, and it originated from England, sporting type of group, size is medium. Then here are the photographs of the English Cocker Spaniel, and I have given some photographs here. Now they are very friendly, outgoing, playful, tendency to bark is very high, good with childs, seniors, families, and dogs and other cats. Grooming requires very high due to their type of coat, long hair, and curly. Other traits are they are very easy to train, apartment friendly, good for novice owners. Pastime owners also, they can start with this dog, Pointer. It comes from England, sporting type, under American classification, UK classification, gun dog, and size is medium size. These are some of the photographs of the Pointer here. So these two photographs, they are used for hunting, or this one of wild duck and all. Temperament, they are very affectionate, even temper, kind, but not particularly easy to train as house pets. Tendency to bark and snore is low. Kids, yes, they are good with the keep. Grooming low due to the short coat. They are having short coat, and they comes under different colors. Now Saint Bernard, again very popular and very heavy dog. It comes from Switzerland and Italy, working class, and UK the classification Guernsey. Very large dog. So see here, their weight comes around 60-70 kg body weight. And they are used as generally at the very beginning, in the earlier time, they were bred for draft. That is, they were used for drafting purpose, and they were used for search and the rescue. Now coming to this one, this is the photographs of the Saint Bernard. You might have seen very huge dog and looks very dangerous, but as such, they are very friendly, watchful, gentle, and calm. Tendency to bark is low and snore is moderate. Good with children, seniors, families, dogs, and cats. And grooming moderately required, as the coat is medium in length. Colors red and white, brindle and white. Other traits are they are easily trained, needs low exercise, good for novice owner, but prone to disease due to their big size. And the food requirement may be lower than that of the other breeds of similar size. See here, Saint Bernard is a very big size dog breed. We think that their food requirement may be very high, but when we compare this dog breed with other dog breeds of the similar size, their food requirement is less because his temperament is more placid and it needs less exercise. Therefore, the food requirement is also low. Coming to the Rottweiler, again, looks very dangerous, but most of the time you might have seen these dogs with the policemen, with the army men and all. Other names are Rott or Rotti. It comes from Germany, so many breeds from the German. Working class groups under American class. Then guardian dog under UK classification. Large to giant, the size is here is 40 to 50 or 60. So their lifespan is around 10 years. Here are the images of the Rottweiler. These are very popular one you might have seen. They look very dangerous when we look into their face directly. However, they are alert, fearless, good nature, independent. Good sweet kids, no. Sometimes might not be the best option for kids. Tendency to bark, moderate. Snore, low. Grooming required, yes, moderate. Colors, black with tan markings. Then what about the other characteristics? Great watchable ability, not good for novice. For the first time owners, this may not be the good breed of choice. Rough Collie. Here it is Scotland and the United Kingdom, the origin. American classification herding, UK classification also herding. Means in the earlier time, so many animals, these like cattle, sheep, and other species. So for controlling those domestic animals, they were used. They are medium to large size breed. And here are the photographs, Rough Collie. Now coming to their temperament, they are intelligent, friendly, and very protective. Tendency to bark is moderate. However, there will be very excessive barking if they are left alone for a long time in your home. Then tendency to snore is low. Good with children, dogs, and the novice. So for the first time owner, it is okay. Grooming is minimal, once in a week is required. Then other traits are they are easily trained or trainable. Breed for herding sheep, a good watch dog. Now coming to the selection of dog breeds here. Coming to there is an infinitive, very size, say coat, texture, etc. Goats are having say of maybe a small size, maybe medium size, maybe large size. They may have different shape, coat, texture. So on the basis of these and the availability of time you have to spend along with your pet animal, so you have to decide which will be the best dog breed for me. Now here, the domestic breed are influenced, but the influence here now we have already here. What are the points we have to consider for selection of a dog breed of my choice? The important points to be considered are their size, whether I need a very big size, medium size, very small size, what type of coat, very short coat, smooth coat, long coat, and because on the basis of their types of coat, that grooming requirement is there. Then whether I like a male dog or a female dog, whether I should start with an adult female or a puppy or pedigree or mongrel. Mongrel means those which are commonly observed in the roads, streets and all, or they don't have any pedigree records. So here size, coming to the giant breeds. Generally, temperamental wise, they are very gentle, quiet, restful, but they need more food. Giant breeds require more food. Are you ready for that? Providing them more food, more medications, boarding canal costs are higher, and they have a very short life. So if you are ready, even with this one also is okay. If you you can provide the food, you can provide, go for the medications requirement. And then other large breeds, they are aggressive generally with other dogs if not properly controlled. Large breeds with full swishing tail can do a lot of damage within the home, because if you are having in your apartment this type of large breed, they are moving tail, wagging of the tail, it may cause a lot of damages in your apartment. Then long hair breeds. If you are going for a long hair breed, they may need an hours of grooming every day, professional training for poodles, bichons, terriers as a regular exercise means. Are you ready to provide your time for grooming every day? Or you should hire one person? Are you ready for training of their hairs? and every day by yourself, or you should go to some parlor or some veterinarians to do the things. So accordingly, you have to decide. Then medium-sized dogs, suit for many families, their home and their car. There is plenty of choice within this group. Medium-sized dogs, you can choose any one of them. Then small dogs, tend to be noisy, as I mentioned already, Pomeranian. Then small miniature Dachshund and all, and they have a very high tendency of barking. So if you are ready for that one also, it is okay. If you are living in a small apartment, keeping this type of dog, then there will be a lot of noise. Sometimes you may think that you are disturbed. So they are generally not suitable with the small children. Very small toy dogs, dogs under 4.5 kg in weight are not really suitable for the rough tumble of family life. Toy dogs tend to become devoted to one or two adults who handle them carefully. Means they have the tendency of attachment with one or two people or person living in the family who are really taking care of them. Then, now coming to the coat type, different breeds. They have different types of coats and each has specific grooming requirement. So smooth-coated dogs require minimal grooming and they used to dry very fast if they are wallowing or they are going for swimming. Long-haired dogs, they need a lot of grooming time and tend to smell when they are wet or damp, because once they are wet, then drying time is required. If they are not properly dry, then smell will come up. Then, do you want to spend lots of time every day on grooming, or you will schedule only permit once in a week? If you choose a breed that requires clipping, trimming, and stripping, are you willing to learn? Would you rather pay someone to do it for you? So these are the points you have to discuss, analyze or consider before choosing a dog breed. So as per the availability of your own time and suitability, you have to decide which one I should go, long type coat or short type coat. Then the answer to these questions can be very important factors when choosing a breed. Okay, you have to decide first of all, what will be the requirements of this type of particular dog breed, and accordingly you have to. Then coming to the male or female dog or breeds, this is one of the major decisions here, when the pen owner should consider while acquiring a dog. In the larger or guarding breeds, males tend to be significantly larger in size, more dominant in temperament, and require farm handling. See, in case of guarding dogs or large breeds, males, they do have a very big size and require a farm handling. Otherwise, they may become very dangerous and out of control. Then, breeds, they are more biddable, more sympathetic, and kindly with children, and often intuitively quicker to define their owner's wish. Means, breeds, they are more sensitive in terms of their behavior towards the children and the owner. On the other hand, bitches can experience mood swings and variable temperament, especially during their Easter cycle. If you are going for a bitch, then there may be a mood swings and a variable temperament when they are under Easter cycle. If you want a dog as a permanent companion to be available for anything the family wants to do, means most of the time if you are interested to have a permanent companion along with you, then the male is perhaps more suitable, unless there are definite plans to control stress in the pitches. So you may go for spaying of the bits if you don't want that one stress cycle, as well as the pups. Then adult or puppy here. Puppies offer their new owners a clean slate, a chance to maul. Means, since they are puppy, you can maul as per your wish. You can train them and you can give more time to accompany him. Then, bringing home a puppy allows you to experience and participate in all the fascinating stages of life. If you have started with a puppy, that means you can experience the different stages of life for a puppy up to the adulthood. And here, the first 6 to 9 months, the first 6 to 9 months of puppy life is very critical or crucial, because it makes the adult dog, which type of dog in terms of their behavior, attitude towards other people, strangers, other dogs, pets, and all. So that will be decided how you have trained your dogs during this particular time that is 6 to 9 months of age. So your lifestyle, availability of time and energy, and the willingness of all members of your family members, all the members are willing to share their time to join the challenging process of raising a puppy. So raising a puppy is just like a raising a child. So in that situation, all of your family members, their involvement is required. If they are ready, then you start with a pup. If you are not ready for these challenging responsibilities now, yes, we cannot do or we cannot spare those times for raising a pup, then consider the alternatives of purchasing or adopting an adult. So now then, what about the adult dog? An adult dog may be obtained. You can obtain an adult dog from a responsible breeder or an owner. This way will offer you the opportunity to own a dog whose foundation has been firmly established by a knowledgeable individual, because you don't need to take care of their childhood. Already that dog has been given the train, proper training and all those things. So those parts is now over. You can have an adult dog of your interest. So most dogs are quite adaptable. If you are thinking that if I purchase one adult dog, whether it can adapt in my family or not, no. Yes, they are quite adaptable. Don't worry for that one. And they can shift into a new living environment also, and with some ease, as long as their basic requirements are met out. Now, selection of pups. Now, let us go for, we have decided that we'll go for pups. Then decide the type of the dog. Now you have decided which breed I should take. Large, medium, or small, long hair or short hair, like that. Then decide the breed of dog after considering your availability of space, whether you are in the apartment or you are having a big house with a compound area and all, temperament of the neighbor, your neighbors, whether they are ready to accept your dog or not, and the compound wall is there or not for your house. Then purchase the pup having the breed characters from a member of a kennel club. So you go, don't purchase from anyone who may influence you. This is the breed of your choice, and this is the breed. So if you are not having very concrete knowledge about the breed, then here most of the pups at the age of 4 to 6 of age, they look very fine and lovable. So then maybe there is where you can purchase. A healthy pup should be fat with bright eyes, but should not be pot bellied. If the pup is having pot bellied, then don't go for that one. And if any bad discharge is there from their eyes or nostrils, then don't go for that type of pup. A boldest and the loveliest pup should be selected from the litters. Means if they are having 5-6 pups from their breeds, then the boldest and the loveliest one, you select it. The one which is hiding behind, don't go for that type of pup. Select the pup which have loose, pliable skin and a glossy coat. Give maximum consideration to the breed conformation. If you are going for Doberman, German Shepherd, Golden Retriever, Pomerania, then you should have the knowledge that this particular pup is having all those characteristics of that particular breed. Pups below average in body weight, say for example, if a pup should have around 5 kg of body weight, as per their age, they should have that one. If they are having lower than that one, then don't go for that type of pup. And when the litter size is very large, say for example, around 8 pups are there, then the size of the pups may be smaller, but they have the tendency to pick up very fast. Then oversort or undersort jaws, when you just look into their jaws, upper and the lower, then if any abnormalities there, don't go for those type of pups with any deformities. Then gums should be pink in color. It shows the health conditions of the pup. The ears should not have any discharge or foul smell. You should check their ears also. Sorry. Tail should not be broken or crooked. You have to feel the tail. Is there any broken part or crooked part? examine all the four limbs, count the number of digits. They should have the equal number. If any extra is here, then better not to purchase that type of part. Then coming to the ribs, rib bones, if any bit or any swelling type, some heart structure is there, in especially in the joining area between ribs and the sternum, you are very familiar with the term sternum, okay, that is the in the ventral part of the chest. So if this type of bit is present, then it is suggestive of rickets. Then such pops will require special attention, or else the bones may be deformed later. Now, purebred or present, purebred and the mixed breed. Purebred, say purebred means what? Your German Shepherd, your Rottweiler, your Saint Bernard, your pup, this one. So in that situation, first it offers a guarantee of what a pup will look like as an adult, the size, coat type, activity level. When we are going for a pup, then you can decide, yes, this particular pup is having all the characteristics of a breed of my interest. So that can be well decided. Second point is temperament of the puppy's mother can be better evaluated. If you are going for purchasing a pup, then that the temperament of the mother of that pup, you can evaluate, you can have the idea from the owner, you can feel it, you can watch it. So in that way, how my pup will behave when it becomes adult on the basis of their mother's temperament. Then when we consider about the mixed breed, or generally called as mutts, as they are sometimes affectionately called, can also make a great pet. They are varied backgrounds, because mixed breed means they are the hybrids from different types of breeds. So due to their different types of backgrounds, they are not having any type of genetic problem. Because they are hybrid, there is more heterozygosity is there, then there is very little chance for expression of those recessive genes responsible for harmful physical characteristics. Thanks all. Up to here. Okay, dear students, today I am completing your class here, and tomorrow at 1 p.m. I will try to take your breeding management of dog and the classification of cats. Okay, all the best. Stay safe.